Hello everybody, this is Blake Cross EXE, and welcome back to Street Pass Plaza. Still working on my street passes from MomoCon 2017, and now we're going to enter the game called Feed Me, where you get to be a chef. Which, you know, works for me, because I actually have a culinary degree in real life anyway. Alright. Ready for this? Make culinary history. So, this takes place in the same universe as Find Me, which is kind of funny, because if Army is the monarch in Find Me, and we're also the chef here, does that mean that we weren't really captured the whole time? We were just hiding out, letting the heroes go off and do whatever? Alright, so, pretty much, the way this works is you'll get an ingredient based on what color of shirt the Miyu Street Pass is wearing. And different ingredients equal different combinations of different foods, and so on and so forth. So, basic kinds of ingredients: meat, vegetables, other stuff. Heroes stop by before going on a quest. Yeah, if you get, and the heroes that you're feeding are going off and trying to save the monarch that's been captured. And the better the meal they have, the more well they perform in battle. So that's the gist of it. Instead of just looking at everything that Crisp is trying to tell us, beef and rice casserole. We're just gonna need some rice, and we're gonna need some beef and some tomato. And well, bam, bam, diggity. We have an artisan beef and rice casserole. Artisan basically just means that it is the highest quality you can get. The only thing you can get higher than that is jumbo, which means if you have all of the ingredients you need plus one or two, then you get a higher rank artisan meal. You know, really simple. Just good luck finding the right ingredients at the right time, especially when we get down to the more obscure ingredients and colors. Alright. So let's, roast beef. Trying to remember what our roast beef needs. I think it needs beef, onions, and maybe potatoes. Alright, let's try beef, onions. I don't think it needs mushrooms. Oh, there we go. Beef and onions. All you needed. We got more roast beef than Arby's up in here. Perfect roast beef on the first try. So then, we see all the bees sitting around the supper table having their fill. And, yeah. That's pretty much all there is to this game. It's really simple, and it's kind of fun. It's not as much fun. It's not like Cookie Mama, where you actually mix the ingredients. You just literally tap the button, and the ingredients combine themselves. Jumbo search leads to the exit. Best food in the world. Oh, I thank you, Gwyn. Cool thing is, after you beat the Find Me 1 route in this, you get to go to the Find Me 2 route. Which does take a lot longer, though. Alright, so, oh yeah, you can also combine ingredients to try to figure out new recipes with whatever ingredients you have left over. And whatever you don't store in the refrigerator gets thrown out at the end of the day. So, let's do some culinary research. Let's just, I'm just gonna cook what I want. I'm just gonna take one of these mushrooms, since I have two of them. And we're just gonna get a roasted mushroom. There we go. Or, not roasted mushroom. Fried mushroom. You know, very simple. Yeah, might make the Mario Bros happy at least. Okay, so now we're gonna leave this game, and we're gonna go play a new one. Flower Town. Let's go ahead and get this one out of the way. I think this is the worst Street Pass game just because it's not very rewarding. It's not very action-packed. It's just growing plants and growing flowers and all that. Did you say all those people and plants are fictitious? I totally wasn't looking at the screen when it said that. Yes, Flower Town. Let's get this over with. This one gets the most annoying, and though I've gotten all the Plaza tickets on my other 3DS, I haven't 100%ed it, because I don't care about getting every plant of every color. It's not worth my time. I haven't even completed all the jobs yet. Hello, Mr. Mendel. That me looks kind of weird. If you're growing food, food plants, then that'd be different, but you're just growing flowers. They look pretty, yeah, but, you know, I wouldn't send her whole game around it. Guess Mr. Vindel's looking for me, and I'm inside, asleep, probably. Because I got bored to sleep with this game. Yep, there I am. Not asleep. Yes, I am Blade Man. Yeah, I'm gonna become the Master Gardener because I have nothing better to do with my life. Yeah, 20 breeds of plants, so on and so forth. I like the purple one. Just gonna come by and water the plants, and that's all there is to it. Just trying to get more seeds and crossbreed more plants, and just make more plants, and that's really all there is to this. I haven't finished most of the jobs on my other 3DS yet, so I don't even know where to begin about talking about jobs. There we go, finally. I think the first round is designed to not let you get any new crossbreeding seeds right off the bat. Alright. Let's just take a look at the Bella Cantata. A symbol of gratitude and honor. Buys a ticket for me, because that's all I'm really here for. Now that I think about it, I think Mr. Bender looks a little bit like Ozpin from Ruby. Not a terrible whole lot, but just a little bit. Let's talk to Gwyn, because you've been good so far. Fruit trees. Okay. Yeah, what are you growing right now? Oh, that's pretty. Alright. What about Abby? What do you have? Okay, what are you growing? Dixie Gold? That's kind of cute. Let's check out your garden. I'll humor you. Let's go look at your plants. Oh, it's nice and small. She's only got 13 journal entries too, so she's not super. No, she is pretty far, I suppose. If there's only 20. S quartz. Okay, what are you growing? A velvet lady. All right. Now this guy with the wizard hat, Xander. So, Xander, what do you have? Hydrista. Alright, yeah, I'll see you later. And, Izzy. Alright, and, what do you have? Ooh, that's pretty. I wonder what that blank one is at the bottom. Okay, I think I'm gonna go back to the work shed now. That's all there is to this game, really, as far as just how do you get more plants and everything. The jobs become available a bit later, I believe, so we're just gonna leave that alone and go back to the plaza. Alright, here we go. Ninja Launcher. This one is pretty fun. It's creative, to say the least. Alright, we're ninjas defending our village from demon invaders. The Blade Man Ninja Clan. Alright, so let's do this. We're gonna use this big old cannon and we're gonna defend ourselves by shooting ourselves out of it. Shinobu, loyal apprentice, will take care of the launching. We get to be the cannonball. And we strip down to our skivvies because our clothes catch fire whenever we're inside the cannon. This sounds like something out of Mario Party. Scrolls have weapons, and they're attached to kites. And you can see the trajectory line right there. There we go. Alright, A is for test fire, Y is for actually shooting. Here we go! Suit, kunai, and ninja hood. I killed the onion head. Alright, and since I've got 10 people in Street Pass, that means I've got quite a big ninja army for myself to use. And I've only got one helmet, which is not good when I encounter enemies who start fighting back. Skeletal minion. Somebody thinks he's Sans. Alright, here we go. Eleanor moves back and forth. All around. Here we go. Chainmail, general armor, ninja hood, knight armor of the future, golden armor, kunai, ninja katana, legendary armor. Boom! 1388. That armor is really shiny. And that's all there is to that game. That's really short and simple. Alright. Next, Slot Car Rivals. If you've ever played Mario Party, the original one, you played Slot Car Derby. Kind of similar. You know, the whole slot car thing, except, you know, you don't crash into each other. Alright, let's do this. This one was actually one of the two that was given out free a while back when they were doing the most recent drop of Street Pass games. Nintendo's still trying to keep the 3DS relevant even with the Switch on the horizon. Of course, these games were released before the Switch even came out, which, you know, was a couple months ago now. And this guy's brother is the Grand Champion. Nico Fire. And his brother is Iceman. Alright. Yeah, let's, just a little basic car. I've heard slot car racing is actually a real hobby. I know nothing about it, so I can't really comment on that, though. So, let's ride. It tricked me. Okay. So you gotta put the car back on the track and slow down when you go around curves. And then if you hit the speed button right as you're at the end of them, you can get a little bonus. Okay, there we go. Yeah, that's enough practice. Let's move on to the actual event now. Just a regular booster. Racing license. You have to have a license to race? Like, I understand in real life for like a real car, but for a slot car? But yeah, we're gonna be the world champion eventually. You know, if I take this to more cons to get more street passes. Alright, let's just race our rivals. I'm only okay at this one. I'm not super great. Took me a lot of time to actually beat everything on my other 3DS. And so they're gonna modify my booster for me, and I get a new one. Ooh, prototype car. Okay, thank you. I do wish the car customization was a little bit better on this one, though. Okay, that's all for that one. And I think we have two games left? Maybe three? Oh yeah, we got three. We got Market Crashers. We have, Meat Trek. Oh, we got four left. Okay. This one... I have a personal grudge against Ultimate Angler because it took me so freaking long to catch every single thing on every single island. I haven't S-ranked everything because I don't care that much about the game, and it's so hard to find people who have the right kind of bait. But during the Street Pass weekends and any con I could go to, I was gathering up as many Street Pass bees as I could and trying to catch all the right fish. And I finally did it and got the last plastic ticket for my other 3DS over there. So the story is basically, we're going fishing and we lose our tackle box here in a minute. I gotta admit, Coraline is kinda cute though. They gave her a nice design. Yeah, the reason we have to recruit people through Street Pass is because we end up losing our tackle box, so we have no bait. I think using the touchscreen is faster than using the joystick. A little tiny sardine. Alright, still got two bait left, so let's go ahead and catch what we can. This one's this blue looking thing. Looks like a Helix fossil almost. There we go. Black rockfish. Rockfish, like a relicanth? Alright, well that's all we can do on this one. but that's the only one I can use. Okay, well, let's just mix and match as many as we can. Yeah, you're gonna help me out. Let's do this. And of course, the gauge in the middle there is how much strain the line is taking, and it might break if we really need to fight. There we go. Japanese sea bass. Delicious. Okay, yeah, we're gonna head back to the clubhouse and then I'm gonna lose my tackle box. Okay, look for the monsters. Legendary monsters on every island. That's unfortunate. That's a big fish. So yeah, that's the mission of this game. You fish out the sea monsters, and you use people through Street Pass to get enough bait to do so. And that guy has an anglerfish ball hanging from his head. Okay, now the tutorial is over. Now we can finally get our bait from our Street Pass friends. I wonder how long this extended vacation is, though. He's been sitting in the hotel for an awful long time. Alright. And like with Feed Me, whatever color bait you get is based on whatever color shirt that the Mii is wearing. So we got a nice little variety going on here. I think. A couple red, one black, and one white. Alright, yeah, let's go to Prelude Island. Yes, yes. There we go. Let's skip this, because not really much but boarding the boat. Alright. Start by mixing some bait first. Alright, we're going for this big one first. And I got a tiny one, so that means it's probably gonna be like a clump of seaweed or an old shoe. Oh, no, it's actually fighting back. So, it's still probably not gonna be that big one I was looking for, though. Nah, it's just a little... little tiny sardine. I wasted all my bait for nothing. Mix the three blue ones to get a big blue one. And let's hope we can actually get the fish we're after this time. See, this is part of the reason why it took me so long to complete it on my other 3DS, because several fish... Aw, come on! I got a clump of seaweed after all that? At least it's an A rank. See, this is why this game gets annoying. If I continue this series outside of the Momocon Street Passes, I may or may not continue playing this game in particular, just because it gets really frustrating at some point, and I doubt I have the patience to try to 100% it for a Let's Play. I need to get a better rod. Another sardine. D rank, even though I used those big baits on it. So yeah, this game deliberately makes you mad. I think this game tries to mock you. I didn't even catch a new species except for seaweed. So, yeah. While I think that the worst Street Pass game is Flower Town because it wastes your time, this one is easily the most annoying. It's annoying because it's difficult and, nah. Well, actually, yeah, let's go ahead and put my sardines in my fish tank. Alright. Let's add my sardine, add my seaweed. Yeah, like I said at the beginning of this little skit right here, I really, really don't like Ultimate Angler. The only reason I kept playing is because I really needed that last plastic ticket to get the last hat. Or actually, it was text bubbles at that point, I think. Alright, two more. Gonna do the other boring one, and then I'm gonna finish off with one of the fun ones. Market Crashers. You're playing the stock market. One thing I have to note about this, though, the frame rate and animation of this game are noticeably better than on the previous ones. Like, look at how fluid the animation is on the Miis in this game in particular. I guess since there wasn't a lot of action or animation elsewhere, they could afford to put more into the animation budget for the moving around inside the game. Why is that person's skin super pale and silver-like? So yeah, we're gonna trade the stock market. Wallace Street. Obviously, a pun on Wall Street. Yeah, I already know how this works. Buy low, sell high. Okay. So when it goes back up, we're gonna sell it. And performance goes up right at the very end. Now, in the actual game, it's not going to stop like that. You're going to have to press buy and sell on the fly. And the more people you street pass, the better your predictions are. The more accurate your predictions are, I should say. $10 billion G. All right, let's do this. So, cool thing I like about this is after you get done buying and trading, you can actually buy stuff with your money. All right, we've got our squad of analysts here. Okay, it looks like we're gonna get better results out of this one, so. Alright, gonna go up first. Okay. Gotta wait for it to go down. There we go. After it goes down. Wow. I botched that one. I wasn't paying attention to the numbers on the front screen. Whoops. I screwed that one up. Ah, they took my money. Eh. This is why I don't play the stock market in real life. Oh, okay. Thank you, Cher. Yeah, I botched that one up badly. I wasn't paying attention to the numbers on the screen before I went into the trading room. Okay, now we end on one of my favorites, and it's actually one of the most interactive games. I clicked the wrong one, but we still need to do this one anyway. Meteorek is you're basically exploring a map looking for treasure, so it's not bad. Although, I haven't 100% of this one yet because I might be doing something wrong. I may not have the right kind of travelers with me, but I just can't find the last few bit of treasures and photographs. So we are adventurers looking for artifacts and relics. It's a bird that talks. Sir Henry Beaksley. And that's how this goes. You street pass somebody, they give you a certain number of steps you can take on your adventure. You apparently can go forever, though. You're leading the quest, and you just got somebody else behind you carrying your backpack. Zoom in on the map using X, and we gotta get to the red X to get the treasure. This treasure's not gonna have anything in it because it's tutorial, though. Gonna need to go up. And we have a backpack with the ancient compass. Not sure how the ancient compass works, but okay. Yes. We just destroyed rocks with our bare hands because we're a boss like that. Oh. I don't want that hippopotamus for Christmas. Ah, tranquilizer dart. Okay. Now we're gonna go this way to get to the treasure. There we go. And it's a statue of Sir Henry Beaksley. Super trendy statue, as it's described. So does that mean we're just taking these and selling them on the street when we get back home? Okay, so now we can actually begin the real quest. It's pretty much the exact same thing, except with me explorers instead of animals. Alright. Which way first? Let's take the long trip. Because most times I like to try to be a completionist. Unless it's just absolutely boring and not worth my time. So I'm gonna try to get as much of this done as I can. Alright, let's get these bags. Good, 5 tranquilizer darts. I got the compass. Okay, now we know where the treasure is. Alright. Find this shrubbery and start chopping. Thanks. Ah, it's a dead end. Okay. So we gotta go this way then. Black Rhino. Aren't those extinct now, or did I hear that wrong? Ah, picture time. Here we go. Got a picture of a macaw. Alright. Let's go through here and grab that bag that we found. Boom headshot. Ah, rapid shot camera. Alright. Running out of steps, so we're not gonna finish this one. Alright. Yeah, that's what we're gonna start up on the next route though. Now we come to the last game of the Street Pass Plaza, Monster Manor, which is a... It's something like a puzzle game, but it's also got action in it. We gotta collect pieces of a map, build the map, and then explore the mansion from within. Alright, let's start the investigation. So we're detectives, apparently. This is pretty much exactly how the beginning of Outlast started, and we know that didn't end well. Even though in Outlast it was an insane asylum and not a haunted manor. But with all the crap that went down, it may as well have been haunted. Just got grabbed by a Wallmaster. Yeah, doors won't open, so we gotta fight our way to the top and kill the final boss. Piece of a map. Now we just gotta find the rest of the map, and we will build the floors. Bottom floor is shaped kind of like a... Actually, it looks kind of like a Google map point. When you connect two pieces that are of the same color, then you get wider rooms, and you can get treasure chests and this thing called the Mystic Orb, which lets you manage your items. There we go. Health plus one. Now this next piece is... different colored, so it's not going to give me any items. But we got an enemy to fight. Alright, what we got? Smiling Ghost, or Smiling Spectre. Gotta be careful with the batteries, or else, well, you're gonna die. There we go. Experience points and your weapon levels up. Alright. So all these people, all this time, are trapped within the manor. Let's do this. They scream funny. Alright, I'm gonna send you to the back. What piece do you have? Yeah, let's get a big one. There we go. Three treasure chests. Miracle Cure, which is good for curing paralysis or poison, I suppose. Ultra Ring, which looks like a banana. And this one actually lets you use a charge attack. Big charge chest. Ooh, skill badge. Alright. Yeah, I can make that one fit. Ah! A met up with myself again, so now we team up and we fight the ghosts together. Alright, let's team up. Alright. Another blue one. Actually, I'm gonna send you to the back, and I'm gonna grab that next red piece that I find. Not gonna be super helpful, but it'll work. Oh, found another person. Do you have an item for me? Ooh, plaza ticket. Heck yeah. Ten gems. Thank you. I wonder when I get the puzzle boxes. I know that was a thing, I just don't remember where or when. Alright, let's take this, I wonder what that rumbling sound was. It's a ghost! Booga booga! Doogie! Just two-shot KO. Alright. Okay, so, and so on and so forth. Nothing in this room. You have a big wonky shaped piece. Ah, another ghost. All too easy. Long stretchy piece. Ah, found the stairs. Not gonna go just yet. I wanna use the last few pieces I have. Send you to the back. Gonna actually, you know what? I am gonna use the stairs because I continue as long as I have puzzle pieces. And we're gonna start on a blue floor because that's where we found the stairs at. And when you reach the end of a floor, you get your HP recovered. And you get an upgrade. And I get a plaza ticket. Good. So, since the next floor starts with a blue, I have a piece to connect it with. Alright. Okay, so, not bad. We'll get one item out of this, I think. Oh, an orb. Okay. Yeah, the orb will let us... Oh, we did get a chest. Okay. Atomic ray gun. And we can switch weapons on the fly, I think. And turn them into gems, and so on and so forth. Nice. Let's upgrade a weapon. I think I'll use the Ultra Wing next. Gonna combine it with this Atomic Ray Gun, and we get a more powerful Ultra Wing. Yes, equip the Ultra Wing. And now we're gonna leave. Nice. Take this little piece right here. And move on to the next area. Another ghost? Yeah. Let's see what the Ultra Wing does. Thank you. Didn't quite get the counter hit on him. Counter hits actually give you more damage, I think. And so that's Monster Manor. Not really much more to say than that. Team up's over now that he's gone. Alright. And now we go back to the plaza. And that ends episode 2 of the Momocon Street Passes. I'm going to continue these as long as I have more Street Passes to work with. And given that I have over 100 more in my line, there's probably going to be at least, I don't know how many more episodes. I may skip over a few games depending on how they go. But yeah, that's pretty much how this little series is going to go. And if possible, I'm going to do this for any more cons I go to if I can get a good sizable number of Street Passes. So thank you so much for watching. This has been Blade Cross EXE, part of Flash and Blade Productions, with the Street Pass Plaza and the Street Passes I got while I was at MomoCon. Alright, thanks for watching.